I'm repeating this again. It is not us who mentioned that that gentleman was seated in that office when these commitment letters were being given. It is the former CEO who confirmed this. It is only fair for that senator to be able to come in front of us and be able to now confirm and say that whether those things that were said were true or not. I feel that the frustrations that Rashid, when I'm speaking, you will switch off your...
A very lucrative institution is in the public domain. It is clear. It has been already announced. What other confirmation do we require from the members?
Yes.
It is there. This is the excesses of the executive,
yes,
of making appointments.
A gentleman who has been promoted and gone to the Communication Authority is someone who was mentioned by Manjari, not by us, by Manjari. Now, these gentlemen who are seated here, none of them has any authority to be able to appoint. When you're doing your report, you can easily be able to state whether someone is unfit to hold public office. It has been done before. It has worked in some cases. And I know that it is frustrating right now that we are going through names and these names are being promoted elsewhere.
Yes.
I can feel it and I understand you. But all I'm saying is that let us use our constitutional powers that you have within your grasp when you're writing your report. What I've equally said is that no one will be mentioned in any way without a right of response. So it is very, very important for us, the fact that these board members were mentioned that they were there. It is very, very vital for us.